فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، My beloved brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He brought us out of our mother's womb and He brought us into this world. We didn't exist. Allah brought us into existence. Allah brought us into this dar, darul dunya. And as time goes on, we will then move from this dunya and then we will move swiftly to the darul barzakh. Barzakh, as the great scholars Ibn Zayd and Dhahhak and others mentioned, is a station between the dunya and the hereafter. And then you're going to finally move on to darul akhirah. So the slave goes through these three dar, darul dunya, darul barzakh, and then he swiftly moves on to darul akhirah. The dar of this world that we're living in, darul dunya, is an opportunity that is being given to you, O slave of Allah, for you to work for the stations and the positions that are going to come on the other side. We were not created to live forever. Every individual has an ending moment. And the barzakh is not eternity. The grave that you're in is a station to the hereafter. Some people, they thought when they saw dead bodies, they thought to themselves that these people are forever going to be dead. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, he said, إِنَّمَا خُلِقْتُمْ لِلْأَبَدِي. You were created to remain forever in the hereafter. وَلَكِنَّكُمْ تُنْقَلُونَ مِنْ دَارٍ إِلَى دَارٍ. But you'll be moved from one station to another station. You were not created to stay in this dunya forever, and you were not created to die forever, but you were created to be in the hereafter forever. You will be moved from one dar to another dar to another dar. ولذلك أبي العلاء المعري, he said, خلق الناس للبقاء فضلت. The people were created to remain, but a group of people became misguided. فضلت أمة يحسبونهم للنفادي. A group of people, they thought they're going to perish and they're going to go. إنما ينقلون من دار أعمالي. The people are being moved from the station of actions. This dunya is a place for you to work. إلى دار شقوة أو رشادي. And you're going to be moved to a place of deeds. يا عبد الله يا أمة الله. The slave of Allah, male and female. You're going to be taken from this world, but you're going to lose an opportunity. That opportunity you're going to lose is you're not going to be able to do any righteous deeds. You're going to be accounted for everything you already did and whatever you've said before, that's what you're going to be accounted for. Al-abdu al-kayyis al-dhakiyyu al-aqil. The slave who is smart, who is clever, is the one who benefits from this opportunity in this world. And he works very hard. He puts every single effort in which he has. Tirmidhi narrated in his Sunan, min hadith Abi Hurairah, that the messenger said, man khafa adlaja. The person who's scared prepares. وَمَنْ أَدْلَجَ بَلَغَ الْمَنْزِلِ And the one who prepares reaches his destination. أَلَا إِنَّ سِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ غَالِيَةَ أَلَا إِنَّ سِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ الْجَنَّةِ Verily, what Allah is going to give you is great and it's high. And what Allah is going to give you is Jannah. The righteous people, they realized that this world is a place of deeds. It's not a place for you to play around. Every minute counts and every second counts. And if that minute goes by, you will never gain it again. So they benefited from it. It is sad today to see our young brothers, who Allah has blessed them with age and effort and strength, standing on the corners of the streets, selling that which is haram, knowing that they're going to finally die one day, selling drugs, that which Allah has made haram from them. And what's sad and how dim-witted this sounds, the place that you're standing and the place where you're selling this drug, there was a person before you selling this drug. He most likely got killed or is in prison and behind bars. And you've been tricked and fooled to believe that you're going to sell this drug, then you're going to repent and then you're going to be righteous. Who promised you this? The people who were promised Jannah whilst walking on this earth and they were told that they're going to enter Jannah, they were still scared. Ibn Abi Mulayka narrated, Bukhari narrated in his Sahih Mu'allaqan, بِسِغَةِ الْجَزْمِ that he said, أَدْرَكْتُ ثَلَاثِينَ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ I met 30 companions of the Prophet, and there was not one of them except he feared hypocrisy. He was scared, he was worried. Amongst these people are those who are promised paradise whilst they're walking on this earth. The only thing that is between them and entering Jannah is death. مَعَذَلِكَ they were scared of hypocrisy. Our young kids, they're not promised paradise or anything, and they dwell deep into selling drugs and harmful things for themselves. And most likely the risks of them entering prison or be killed, hadith wala haraj, is very high. How much can shaitan fool you? And if you do die, who's going to help you on the other side? No one can do anything for you. The people who forsake you in this world are also going to forsake you in the hereafter. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was going to do Umrah and he was with his companions and he came to a place called Abwa, a place where his mother was buried. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ista'dhantu Rabbi, I took permission from my Lord and Azura qabra ummi, so I can visit my mother's grave. The Prophet is taking permission from Allah if he can go and visit his mother's grave. Fa'adhina li, Allah permitted it for me. And so the Prophet went to his mother's grave. And then he said, فَاسْتَأْذَنْتُ رَبِّي And then I asked my Lord, if I can ask forgiveness from my mother, فَلَمْ يَأْذَنْ لِي Allah said, you can't. Our Prophet, Nabiullahi Muhammad, Khalilullah, the one who is the most closest to Allah, is unable to do anything for his mother. Our Prophet couldn't do nothing for his mother. He can't even ask forgiveness for her. How is your friend who's on the street with you do anything for you? Allah told us in the Quran that Nabiullah Ibrahim, he spoke to his father, the second man most beloved to Allah, Ibrahim, Khalilullah. Nabiullah Ibrahim went to his father. He said, Ya Abati, Inni qad ja'ani min al-ilmi ma lam yatika fattabi'ni ahdika siratan sawiyya. Ya Abati, la ta'bud al-shaytan, inna al-shaytan kana lil-rahmani asiyya. يا أبتي إني أخاف أن يمسك عذاب من الرحمن فتكون للشيطان وليا Ibrahim spoke to his heart, his father from his heart. He spoke to him deeply, but his father chose not to listen. His father turned away from the reminder of his father. So Nabiullah Ibrahim's father died. And our Prophet told us that the day of judgment, Nabiullah Ibrahim is going to see his father. And his father is going to come to him. And he's going to grab Nabiullah Ibrahim. And he's going to say, my son, I am not going to disobey you today. And Ibrahim said, but I spoke to you before. He said, today I will listen to you. Tell me what you want. And then Ibrahim will turn to Allah and he will say, oh Allah, you made a covenant and a promise with me that you're not going to hurt me today. And what is more harmful than seeing my father in this state? His father has on his face, al-ghabara was-sood. His father's face is dark. His father's face is dusted. And this is a reflection of what's in his father's heart. His father's face is dark because of the pain and agony. So Ibrahim says to Allah, take my father out of this agony and this pain. Allah said, I made a promise that I will not take a disbeliever to paradise. A disbeliever will go to the hellfire. Ibrahim, Khalilullah, he couldn't do anything for his father. You have those two individuals, Nabiullah Muhammad, and you have Nabiullah Ibrahim. Both of them were unable to do anything for their own parents. What is anyone going to do for you? Afiqu min nawmikum al-amiq. My beloved brothers and sisters, wake up and smell the coffee. Parents, who this responsibility is upon you. The Prophet said, مَا مِنْ عَبْدٍ يَسْتَرْعِهِ اللَّهُ رَعِيَةٍ يَمُوتُ يَوْمَ يَمُوتُ وَهُوَ غَاشُ لِلْرَعِيَةِ إِلَّا حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ. These kids are your responsibility. You gave birth to them. Wallahi, if you forsake that responsibility, the Prophet told us that the hellfire will be made, paradise will be, Jannah will be made haram from you. Remember the responsibility of your children. Buying them every gadget, letting them go out whatever time they want, sitting in coffees and talking about politics that doesn't benefit you. Whilst your children are on the streets selling drugs and you don't know the reality that they're in. Youngsters and youth, you have no rights to say my parents didn't cultivate me correctly. The haq has come to you. You can choose which path you take. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, الإمام عبد الحق الإشبيلي رحمه الله, he has a kitab called العاقبة في أحوال الآخرة, and also Al-Qurtubi in his kitab التذكرة. Both of them mention that Ali ibn Abi Talib رضي الله تعالى عنه, somebody brought him a cup one day. They bought him a cup of water. أنه أوتي بإناء ماء ليشرب, so he can drink from the water. فأخذه ونظر إليه. Ali looked at the water. He observed the cup. He looked at it from every corner. And then Ali said a very powerful statement. He said, الله أعلم. Allah knows best. لكن كم فيك من عين كحيل وخد أسيل. He said to him, how much is inside you, O cup, a person's cheek and a person's eyes? This cup is made out of the earth swallowing you. When the person is buried, the people utilize the earth and they make cups out of it and they make houses out of it. As Allah said in the Quran, قَدْ عَلِمْنَا مَا تَنْقُصُ الْأَرْضُ مِنْهُمْ وَعِنْدَنَا كِتَابٌ حَفِيظٌ. Allah said, we know how this earth swallows its people. So this cup that we're drinking from and these houses that we're living in is most likely a person's body part. That's the reality of what you're going to be. And that's where you're leading to, and that's where you're heading, every single individual. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, O slave of Allah, wake up. ولذلك يزيد ابن أبان الرقاشي, who was the student of Anas ibn Malik, one day he said, يا معشر الناس, O people, ألا تبكون, will you not cry, وتنوحون على أنفسكم, and will you not wail over yourselves, باقي حياتكم, as long as you live, من الموت موعده, who is that death is going to be his final ending, والقبر بيته, and the grave is going to be your true house, والثرى فراشه, and the earth is going to be your mattress. Today you go to the shop, you buy the most beautiful, the greatest mattress from DFS, and you buy it and you make sure it's comfortable. That day your mattress is going to be your grave. وَالدُّودُ أَنِيسُمْ. Today the friend that you're hanging around with, the person that you accompany, is the person who's rich, who's got money. But that day, the person you're going to be in his company are insects, who all they wait for is to pierce through your body and to eat it. وَهُوَ مَعَ هَذَا. With all of that, what awaits you is الْفَزَعِ الْأَكْبَرِ, the great fearful day awaits you. ثُمَّ لَا يَعْرِفْ. And then my slave brothers and sisters, you do not know after all of that. You don't know whether you're going to Jannah or you're going to go to hellfire. وَلِذَلِكَ يَزِيدْ ابْنُ الْأَبَانَ الرَّقَاشِ used to say after that, وَيْحَكَ يَا يَزِيدِ. Destruction be to you, Yazid. مَنِ الَّذِي يُصَلِّ عَنْكَ. Who is the person who's going to pray on your behalf? Once you're dead, who's going to pray for you? He misses prayer. He misses the righteous deeds that he used to do. Then he said, مَنِ الَّذِي يَصُومُ عَنْكَ. Who is the person who's going to fast on your behalf? مَنِ الَّذِي يُرْضِي عَنْكَ. Who is going to then ask Allah to be pleased with you? My beloved brothers and sisters, you don't know where your situation is going to be. ولذلك ميمون ابن مهران, he mentions that he said, لقد أدركت, I met من استحي, من أستحي, من كنت أستحي أن أتكلم عنده. I feared, or I met, and I reached a people who I was shy in speaking in their presence. وقد أدركت, and I met من لم يكن يتكلم إلا بحق أو يسكت. I met a group of people. If they spoke the truth. If they were silent because they had to be silent. وَأَدْرَكْتُ عَنْ أَيْمَتْ مَنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ يَمْلَوْ عَيْنَيْهِ. A person who will never look up, he will fully not look at the sky. عَيْنَيْهِ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ خَوْفًا مِنْ رَبِّهِ. Because of his fear, the fear in which he had of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maymun ibn Mihran, one day he felt that his heart became slightly darkened and tainted. So Maymun ibn Mihran, he said to his son, يَا بُنَيَّ, my son, take me to Hassan al-Basri. So he took him by the hand, his son, and he took him. And at this time, Maymun ibn Mihran was blind. Al-Imam ibn Sa'ad mentions this in his Tabaqat. He took him by the hand, and then he took him to Hassan al-Basri. When he came upon Hassan al-Basri, and Hassan al-Basri saw Maymun ibn Mihran, Hassan al-Basri said to Maymun, what is it that brought you? Maymun said, my heart is a bit dark, and I feel that my heart is not as it used to be. And then he said, can you give me words that will enlighten me, words that will uplift me and increase my iman? And then he said to him, أَفَرَأَيْتَ إِمَّا تَعْنَاهُمْ سِنِينَ ثُمَّ جَاءَهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يُعَدُونَ مَا أَغْنَى عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يُمَتَّعُونَ. Allah says in this verse, أَفَرَأَيْتَ إِمَّا تَعْنَاهُمْ سِنِينَ. Do you not see, O Muhammad, if we give them a time in which they enjoy themselves, they spend a portion of their life in this world, they enjoy themselves. ثم جاءهم, and then it comes to them, ما كانوا يعدون, that which has been promised to them, ما أغنى عنه ما كانوا يمتعون, that which they used to do and the fun that they used to have will not suffice them from what is going to be waiting for them. My beloved brothers and sisters, wake up, work hard, put efforts in. Our Prophet, who Allah told us in the Quran is forgiven for his past and his upcoming sins, Aisha said, he used to pray until his legs would swell. And she would say to him, are you going to pray this much when you know Allah has forgiven you? And the Prophet would say, أَفَلَا أَكُونَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Am I not going to be a slave who is thankful towards his Lord? My beloved brothers and sisters, who I today see their faces, I haven't seen your faces in the masjid before, and this is an opportunity to benefit from. Brothers, I will give you one thing. If all of that which I said in the khutbah did not penetrate through to your heart, I'm just going to say one thing to you. The reason why you're dwelling into this problem is because you distance yourself from the masjid. And anyone who distances himself from the masjid, as the Prophet told us, in the dhiba, the wolf, يأكل الغنم القاسي, the wolf will only eat the goat that's walking alone. You left the masjid, you left the circles of knowledge, and you're by yourself on the street, vulnerable, weak. Shaitan has taken that opportunity from you. Brothers and sisters, wallahi, the friend that you're listening to, the drug dealer who's telling you to sell the drugs, the one you're adhering to, wallahi, the day of judgment, he will free himself from you. اتَّبَرَّأَ الَّذِينَ اتُّبِعُوا مِنَ الَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوا وَرَأَوُوا الْعَذَابَ وَتَقَطَّعَتْ بِهِمُ الْأَسْبَابُ وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوا لَوْ أَنَّ لَنَا كَرَّةً فَنَتَبَرَّأَ مِنْهُمْ كَمَا تَبَرَّأُوا مِنَّا كَذَلِكَ يُرِيهِمُ اللَّهُ أَعْمَالَهُمْ حَسَرَاتٍ. That day, that individual will walk away from you and he would have nothing to do with you. Today is your opportunity to turn away from him and turn away to the remembrance of Allah and connect your heart to the masjid. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اغفر لنا هزلنا وجدنا وخطأنا وعمدنا وكل ذلك عندنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. رب آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأقم الصلاة.